Hi friends, welcome to EduTab. So welcome to the Everyday at 5 series for IBPS AFO 2018-19 brought to you by EduTab. Now friends, this is a regular series wherein each day we come up with a discussion and certain MCQs on a important topic in agriculture. So far we have been covering horticultural crops and now we have moved towards agricultural engineering. So friends, we have been getting a lot of queries regarding this particular topic. So we thought let us just come up with certain MCQs and let us make this session interactive, wherein we will come up with certain MCQs plus we will put forth certain questions as well, right? So even you all need to participate, give your answers in the comment section below. So let us begin with today's lecture. So before that, the courses that EduTab offers for IBPS AFO 2019, one, we have a full video course including the test series, and for each of the topics in agriculture you would get concept notes, videos, summary sheets, MCQs and worksheets, plus you would also be given current affairs, plus there's also inclusion of test series of 25 full-length mock tests and 25 sectional tests, right? And this particular course can be availed for a price of ₹2499 till 2nd of November 2018. Then there's a separate test series as well, wherein there are 25 full-length tests and 25 sectional tests along with detailed PDF solutions. You can avail this course for a price of ₹1499. Okay, so as part of the previous lecture, that is lecture number 9, there were certain questions that I put forth. Okay, so let us just change the way we have been discussing. What we'll do is, the questions that were given yesterday, let me just discuss the answers of those questions. Then I'm going to put forth 4 questions for you guys. I'm not going to tell the answers for those questions in this lecture. Kindly come up with the answers, write them down in the comment section below, and comprehensively we will discuss them in the coming days. Okay, so let us come up with more and more questions. Let us discuss the answers for those. Then at the end we shall come back and have a quick discussion upon this particular chapter, which is agricultural engineering, right? So the one question that I put forth yesterday is, you need to list down certain primary tillage implements and secondary tillage implements. Okay, so first, fairly you need to know the names of it, because in examination there might be a simple question as well where you are asked to eliminate or where you are asked to pick up a particular primary tillage implement or a secondary tillage implement among the options given. Okay, so the first step is, you need to know the names of it very thoroughly. Okay, so when you talk about the primary tillage implements, there is indigenous plough, it is also called country plough. Okay, there is this moldboard plough, both of these can be animal drawn. Okay, now when you talk about those primary tillage implements which are tractor drawn, that can also be moldboard plough. Okay, there is this disc plough, there is subsoil plough and chisel plough. Okay, so basically when you talk about primary tillage operations, it is the first step in the entire process of tillage. Okay, so you are using a very basic equipment called plough, but over the time this plough has also become mechanized and there are various variations of it which are used, and that is all these equipments or implements that you can see on your screens. So basically always keep in mind that when you're talking about primary tillage, the first thing that needs to come to your mind is ploughs. Okay, so now make sure you know the names of these very well. Moving ahead, the names of the secondary tillage implements, okay, they are harrows, there are planks, rollers or pulverizers, there are cultivators. Okay, these cultivators are also known as tiller or tooth harrows. Okay, so there are various type of secondary tillage implements that are used in India. Okay, basically we are talking about harrows in specific here. So the type of harrows which are used in India, you have disc harrow, which is very popular, you have spring tooth harrow, there is spike tooth harrow, there's an implement which is called binda. Okay, so this is nothing but spike tooth harrow made up of a local material in a particular region. Okay, there is acme harrow, there is patela, you have blade harrows. So yesterday I had put forth a question regarding examples of blade harrows. Okay, so here you can see the names are bakhar, Guntaka and Bodela. Okay, all these three fall under the category of blade harrows, but there are certain variations. In the coming sections, whenever we are discussing the chapter in detail, we shall have a look at it, right? Then there is triangular harrow, there is the zigzag harrows and other harrows. We are not mentioning everything out here. Okay, so here you can see the names, so kindly be aware of these names as well. Okay. Now, there was one other question that I put for that, name one implement, okay, that is used for both primary and secondary tillage operations. Now, friends, you need to understand that in these modern days, there is a concept of conservation tillage. Okay, so even I had taken a live session on tillage topic, and in that live session, very elaborately, we had discussed about the various types of tillages that exist. Okay, so one among the classification of tillages into conventional and conservation. Okay, so when you talk about conservation tillage, you are opting for minimum tillage practices. Okay. So, in this kind, what we prefer when we talk about minimum tillage practices is that we want to use lesser implements, or lesser number of implements rather, okay, so that the repeated activities that are performed in the soil is reduced. Okay, so there are many other reasons as well. So now what we can do is we can combine certain implements. So here is an implement which is called rotavator. Okay, so this is used for both primary as well as secondary tillage implements. Okay, this is an example, so kindly keep that in mind. Then the next important question that we put forth was, what are the tillage implements which are used for rice cultivation? Okay, so there are specific implements for it. One is cage wheels, okay, and others puddler. So this puddler is used for an important operation that is called puddling. Okay, this is performed in the case of rice cultivation. So basically, this is done in standing water. Okay, so now there's another question that was put for that, what is the standard depth that is usually preferred in case of puddling operations? Okay, so the answer to this particular question is 5 to 10 centimeter. Okay, they might ask a question where they are directly asking you the depth of the standing water. So this is important. Okay, now friends, whenever you are studying tillage, I would always advise that, you know, combine it with the implements and study. Okay, because if you study it separately, what happens is your understanding is not created, the linkage is not there, and because of that, it becomes tough for us to understand what are the implements that are used. Okay, so if you simultaneously study the tillage, the types of tillage and its implements, it becomes easier to understand what is going on. Okay. Fine. Now here comes, there are four questions here. Okay, these are not exactly on tillage only, but we have included other topics like tractor as well. Okay, so we are trying to cover agricultural engineering as a whole. Okay, so now you need to tell me the answers of these questions in the comment section below. Again, tomorrow we shall discuss the answers of it. Okay, so which of the following is an example of walking type tractor? Okay, so you need to tell me the example name. The options being power tiller, there is disc harrow, there is chain tractor, there is crawlers, and there is wheel type tractor. Okay, so which among the following is an example of walking type tractor? Very important question. Next question that is there is, which was the first country, okay, to use the power tiller on a large scale? Okay, so we are talking about the first country. Okay, again, we have framed this question on power tiller because there might be questions on the origin or the usage of these particular implements in various countries. Okay, so the answer you need to tell me among the options of India, Japan, USA, Australia and Indonesia. Okay, if possible, tell me the year also in which it was first used. Okay, so you can say that two questions are here, which country and the year in which it was first used, right? Okay, so the third question that is there is, what is the depth of the cut that is made by the rotary plow? Okay, now it may seem that they are going too much into technicalities, but you need to have at least a rough idea of the cuts that are usually made in the initial process of primary tillage operations. So for primary tillage operations, we also use rotary plow. Okay, now you need to tell me the depth of the cut. Okay. So the next question that you need to answer is, what is the field capacity of the power tiller? Okay, that is tractor drawn basically. So the options are 2 hectares per day, 1.5 hectares per day, there is 2.5 hectares per day, 0.5 hectares per day, or none of the above, right? So you need to come up with this answer. So yesterday also we had discussed the field capacity of one of the implements, right? So now you need to elaborate it and try and know the field capacity of the other important implements as well, right? So friends, if you have any query about our course, so you can drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can also give us a call at 814-620-7241. So friends, with this, we have come to the end of this particular lecture 10 today. So basically, this particular topic of agricultural engineering is thought to be tough, but actually it is the simplest of all. Only the right approach is needed to cover this particular chapter. And we shall do it with you. We can move along. We can solve a lot of MCQs through which we shall learn a lot of things, right? And at the end, you would see that this chapter is actually going to be a cakewalk for us when it comes to the examination. Now, if you found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. You can also download the PDF format of this particular lecture from EduTab's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens. Plus, you can find the link in the description box of this video as well. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.